my Christian life started about, no, gotta start all over again. Okay. Many years ago, we were renting houses, and we decided one time we were going to buy a home. And we ended up buying a little house that sits right across the street from our church. And much to my surprise, when I got in there, it was just really not what I expected, and I was so sad that we had bought it, but my husband assured me it would be a nice home. He would make it a nice home for me. And during that time of living there, we weren't living for the Lord. I had no intentions of it. And my son saw little children coming into church, my son Rob, my oldest son. And he would see the kids playing out here, and he'd say, "Mom, let's go over there, let's go over there." And I was quite sure at that time I really didn't want to, but my mom had taught me to write Oral Roberts for prayer, because he kind of was our substitute pastor when she got out of church. And so I wrote, and he sent me a letter and said to not forsake the assembling of ourselves, and he sent me a book about seed faith, and I read that, and I knew I had no choice but to come to church, so I came and brought my son for a couple of years, and my sons, and it took me a couple of years to get saved, and finally in 1972 I got saved, and I've been in church ever since. In this church, we started the Gethsemane in 1977, and I'm just so thankful to God that He put us in a little house that I didn't really want to be, and for a son that just continued to prod me to come. And he's a deacon in another church, and I'm just thankful to God for all that He has done. And I just tell everyone, just never give up on God, because He'll never give up on you.